Dear friends, welcome to the second lecture on surface chemistry. In last lecture, we had seen about the introduction of the surface chemistry as well as the principles of adsorption, types of adsorptions and factors affecting the adsorption process. And the link for those that lecture, I will keep it on the description box, so you can easily avail that, go through this first lecture. Now we will start with the second lecture. I welcome, I am Dr. Kirti Kumar Patel from NB Mehta Science College Bordi. I welcome you to the second lecture on surface chemistry. Here we will be dealing with Friedlich adsorption isotherm. But before going through that, we will just have a recap of the first lecture. What we had seen it in the first lecture is that the types of molecules. There are different types of molecules. We had seen about the two types of molecules. One is the surface molecules and the other which are present on in the bulk, inside the bulk. What we had seen it is that in the bulk molecules which are surrounded by other similar types of molecules from all sides, so they face a symmetric force of attractions, force of intermolecular forces of attractions from all sides, and because of that, what happens is that the molecule which is inside the bulk will have a balanced force in all the directions, and hence its energy will reduce. It will not be, overall there will not be any force experienced by this bulk molecule. But when we see it on the surface molecules, which are present on the surface, so that there is nothing on the top of it, so the force of attraction from the top is missing, and because of that there is a net inward pull in the force of attractions among the molecules, and because of that the energy of this surface molecules increases, and so it has a higher energy. Surface molecules will have higher energy than the bulk molecules. Because of this, what happens is that the surface molecules will always tend to reduce this energy, and in the process of doing so, what happens is that it will be accumulating molecular species on the surface, and the process of accumulation of the molecular species on the surface of the solid or a liquid is called as adsorption. So it results into adsorption process. What happens in the adsorption process is that these molecules which are on the surface, due to asymmetric forces, it tries to capture the molecules which are just above the surface in the atmosphere, so they will be just trapped, and a layer will be formed over it. This layer, what happens is that it will try to interact with the surface molecules, thereby reducing the surface molecules' energy. The molecules which are getting adsorbed from the atmosphere onto the surface of the solid or liquid are called as adsorbate, and the molecules which are providing the surface are called as adsorbent. So the solid or liquid layer which provides the surface for adsorption process to carry out is called as adsorbent, and the molecules which are trapped or get stuck on the surface of the molecules, surface of the adsorbent, are called as adsorbate. So we have two different types of molecules, adsorbate and adsorbent. We had also seen three types of processes. One is adsorption, the other is absorption, and the third one is desorption. In absorption, what happens is that the molecules are spread out inside the bulk also. So it is uniformly spread inside the bulk, then we call it as a process as absorption. While in adsorption, it is only on the surface of the solid or a liquid. If the molecules are sticking, then it is called as adsorption. Desorption is a reverse process of adsorption, where already stuck molecule is going into the atmosphere back, then we call it as a desorption. Desorption is a reverse process of adsorption. Similarly, we had seen different types of adsorption processes. One was a physical adsorption and second was a chemical adsorption, depending on the type of interactions that they are making. In physical adsorption, we have physical forces such as weak van der Waals forces are interacting amongst the adsorbed molecules, that is adsorbate, and that of the adsorbent. If the interaction is type of a van der Waals interactions, weak van der Waals interactions, then we call such adsorption as a physical adsorption or a physisorption. this physical adsorption, as it is due to van der Waals interactions, so it varies not only for the first layer, but it is also present weakly for the second layer and third layer and subsequent layers also. Although the interaction decreases, but still there is certain amount of interactions present between the third layer also and second layers also. So because of this, we generally follow in a physical adsorption, a multimolecular layers are formed. So a multimolecular layer is formed in a physical adsorption. While in a chemical adsorption, there is a requirement of formation of a chemical bond between the adsorbent molecules and the adsorbate molecules. And because it is a formation of a chemical bond, it requires a particular distance. That is, bond distance needs to be maintained. And because of that, the second layer of adsorption does not happen. It is only a monomolecular layer is formed, not the multimolecular layer like that of a physical adsorption. So here we have a monomolecular layer formation only and not the multimolecular layer formation in chemical adsorption. Then we had seen about the factors affecting the adsorptions. We had seen four different types of factors affecting adsorption. The first one was nature of adsorbent, that is the nature of solid or the liquid surface. As larger the surface, more will be the area, surface area available for adsorption. So more will be the amount of adsorption that can be carried out. Second is the nature of adsorbate or the molecules that are getting stuck on the adsorbent. So nature of adsorbate becomes the second factor which affects the adsorption. In this case, we had seen that easily liquefiable gases, those gases which are easily liquefiable, those can be easily adsorbed also. Like for example, the methanol or that of a water or ammonia can easily be adsorbed because they are polar, so they are easily liquefiable. Similarly, heavier molecules like nitrogen can be easily adsorbed than the hydrogen. So, nature of adsorbate depends on two things. One is easily liquefiability, that is polarity of the molecules, as well as the amount of molecular weight. Heavier molecules will be easily adsorbed, as well as more polar molecules will be easily adsorbed. The third criteria that we had seen was that of a temperature. And as we had seen that the surface molecules tends to decrease the energy. As they are decreasing the energy during adsorption, so it becomes an exothermic process as it releases the energy. So as the release of energy is there, so it is an exothermic process. And according to Lee-Chatelier's principle, we know that the amount of adsorption will increase with decrease in temperature. This is what we see it in the physical adsorption, that as the temperature is increased, the amount of adsorption or the extent of adsorption decreases. What is extent of adsorption that we had seen was the X is the amount of gas that is getting adsorbed over the M amount of adsorbent. So this is the amount of adsorbate which is getting adsorbed on a fixed amount of adsorbent. So it is a extent of adsorption or the amount of adsorption that is happening. So this ratio X by M will decrease as the temperature will increase for a physical adsorption. What happens in a chemical adsorption is that it requires an energy of activation. As it requires an energy of activation, so first it increases with increase in temperature, reaches the maximum, and then it starts decreasing. Because beyond this temperature, the energy of activation is easily available. So the amount of adsorption decreases with increase in temperature. This was what we had seen it for the adsorption temperature effect on the adsorption. The fourth factor that we had seen was the pressure. And we had seen that as the more number of gas molecules are present in the atmosphere in vicinity, there is a more chance of getting adsorbed on the surface. And so the adsorption increases with increase in pressure. So according to Lee-Chatelier's principle, the increase in adsorption increase in pressure will increase the extent of adsorption. This is what we can see it from the graphs also, that is the extent of adsorption increases with increase in pressure for a particular temperatures. If we keep the temperatures constant, the adsorption increases. But we also see that as the temperature is increased from say 195 to 244 Kelvin, the amount of adsorption decreases. But with pressure, it is increasing. This particular graphs, which are carried out at a particular constant temperature, we call it as isotherms. Iso means constant and therm means temperature. That is, those graphs which we are plotting it at constant temperature are called as isotherms. So this was for the factors affecting pressure or the pressure effect on the adsorption. As there are three different variables for this, that is the amount of adsorption or extent of adsorption, temperature and pressure, we can plot three different types of graphs by keeping any one of these quantities constant and varying the other two. So we can have three different graphs, the isotherms, isobars and isostars. So we can have three different graphs, isotherms, isobars and isostars. So for isotherms, what we see is that we vary the amount of adsorbent or the extent of adsorption and pressure at a constant temperature. When we plot these graphs at a constant temperature, this we call it as a isotherms. These are very important as far as the adsorption process studies are concerned. The second graph that we can plot is that isobars. Isobars means constant pressures. So those graphs which are plotted at constant pressure by varying the extent of adsorption with temperature, those are called as isobars. These are varying in this particular order, where for a particular pressure we have this graph. Third one is isostars. In isostars, what we do is that we keep the constant adsorption and we vary the pressure and the relative pressure as well as the temperature inverse. So the reciprocal of temperature is plotted on an x-axis and a relative pressure on the y-axis, we get a straight lines with negative slopes. This is for the isostars. Generally we study the isotherms and not the isobars as well as isostars, because these are difficult to maintain, while it is easier to maintain the temperature constant during the process. So we can study the isotherms rather than isobars and isostars. The adsorption isotherms, in this the process of adsorption is studied through graphs known as adsorption isotherms, where the graph is plotted between the amount of adsorbate on a particular amount of adsorbent, that is the x by m ratio or extent of adsorption is studied against the pressure at a constant temperature. The graphs are initially it is linear and then curves and then gets stabilized. What we see is that at a particular pressure called as saturation pressure, beyond this pressure, whatever may be the increase in pressure, there is no significant increase in extent of adsorptions. This can be true for, as we know that for a surface, there is a limited quantity of surfaces available. As there is a limited quantity of surface, so there are limited vacancies, vacant spaces are available for adsorption process to occur. So because of this limited number of vacancies that are present, only a limited amount of adsorbent gas can be adsorbed on this surface. And because of that, after a particular level of pressure, there is no more increase in adsorption with a pressure. So adsorption becomes independent of the pressure. That is, this particular stage is reached where the graph is approximately parallel to x-axis. So with increase in pressure, there is no more increase in the extent of adsorption is seen. At high pressures, a stage is reached when all the sides are occupied, and further increase in pressure does not cause any difference in the adsorption process. So that we call it as a saturation stage has been reached, or a particular level is reached. There are different theories to study this adsorption isotherms. One is Friedlich adsorption isotherms. This was given by Herbert Friedlich in the year 1909. The second one was given by Langmuir in 1916, the Langmuir adsorption isotherms. Then for multimolecular layers, Bett equation is followed and Bett equation is there. Other than this, there are other theories also, like Dubinin, Rodoshkevich isotherm theory. Then we have Redlich, Peterson theory. We also have Temkin theory or Temkin isotherms. These are also explaining the adsorption isotherms in different types. But in our syllabus, we have only these three. So we will be studying these three types only, that is Friedlich adsorption isotherm, Langmuir adsorption isotherms, and the Bett equations. And we will not study the other theories. So first we will start with Friedlich adsorption isotherm. As I had said, it was given in 1909 by Herbert Friedlich by observing various different types of processes, different types of adsorption processes. He developed an empirical equation to estimate the amount of adsorption with the pressure. The variation of amount of adsorption with pressure was studied, and an empirical equation was given by Friedlich. That equation is x by m is equal to k into p to the power of 1 by m, where, as we know, the x is the amount of adsorbate that is getting adsorbed over amount of adsorbent m. P is the pressure of the adsorbate, that is the gas that is getting adsorbed. If it is a liquid, then instead of P, we will have concentration term, that is C. K and N are the constants. So these are integral constants. So K and N will be the constants, while X upon M, that is extent of adsorption, then will be directly proportional to P. This is an empirical equation, a simple equation. This equation, when we see it experimentally, like for adsorption process of acetic acid over charcoal, this type of graph is observed, where initially it is a linear, then so a curve is there, and finally it gets saturated at a particular pressure levels. So after that concentration of acetic acid, there is no more increase in the extent of adsorption is observed. This equation, that is x upon m equals k into p to the power of 1 by n, can be simplified further by taking log on both sides, that is log of x upon m equals log of k into p to the power of 1 by n. This second term, right hand side term, can be expanded by using the relation log of a into b equals log of a plus log of b, like log of x by m equals log of k plus log of p to the power of n. By using the expression log of a to the power of n equals n log of a, we get log of x by m equals log of k into 1 upon n log of p. This equation is of the type of y equals mx plus c, or it gives a straight line. If we plot log of x by m versus log p, if we plot log p versus log of x by m, we should get a straight line. That is this type of straight line, where log of x by m, or log of extent of adsorption over the y-axis, and log of pressure on the x-axis, we will get a straight line with slope equals to 1 by n, and intercept on the y-axis will be equal to log k. This can be used to find out the constants n value as well as k values. So this becomes a very easy method to find out the constants k and n values from this particular Friedlich adsorption isotherms. But it has also certain limitations. Although it is easier to implement, but it has certain limitations. The first limitation is that it is a purely empirical equation and has no theoretical basis. That is, how to derive this, we don't know it, or on what basis it has come up also is not known for it. So it is a purely an empirical equation. The second is that the equation is valid over a certain pressure range, not for the complete pressures. It fails at higher pressures. Why there is a saturation, it does not explain to us. Third thing is that the constants K and N vary with temperature. So this becomes a little difficult to carry forward from one process to another process. So that is, these are the limitations for Freundlich adsorption isotherms, which are very important for exams. Thank you very much for this lecture. We will see it in our next lecture, the Langmuir's adsorption isotherms, and the further other adsorption isotherms, we will be watching it in the next lectures. Thank you very much.